What's up, YouTube? SleepyBear20 here, and just want to let you know that this was one of the craziest games I ever played. The whole entire first half, my controller was delaying with the game. Like, I will press a button, and it'll take like 2 seconds for the game to react. So it was like a whole bunch of stuff was going wrong. Like, my lineman got a pick, but I accidentally passed it back because I pressed triangle, tried to catch the ball, but it delayed, and then I wind up losing the touchdown for that. So I hope you enjoyed the video, because I didn't. It was a lot of stress going on, but somehow I still won the game. I hope you enjoy.
Charles and I set for this Madden Ultimate Team matchup as we get a peek some of the stars in today's game. Well, will they be stars? Will you be a star? We'll find out. Let's play. Set to go now on a beautiful sunny afternoon. And we are underway from Heinz Field. It's a short kick taken near the 18. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. Here's carry number one for Jordan Howard. And oh, right away, he lost the football. And this is scooped up by the Lions. And his guys will take over at the 30-yard line.
To put it mildly, that is not the way anyone wants to start off a game. You fumble on your first offensive snap. But now what you're worried about, no one expects to run out on the field on the first play and have to all of a sudden start to play themselves.
And they'll start this drive with very good field position. They come out with one back and three tight ends. They'll run with White. And he'll lose yardage. Brought down at the 32. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down. So the Lions go backwards there, and unfortunately that's something they saw a lot in 2015. They had the fewest rushing yards of any team in the NFL.
As one of those dubious titles that no one really wants to claim, even teams who say, well, I'm worried about running it because we throw it all the time. Being able to run it when you want to is a key to success in the NFL, and Detroit struggled doing that.
On second down, here's Stafford. And a quick throw here, that's complete. That throw good for only a couple. It brings up third down.
The goal of a wide receiver screen is get enough blockers in front to create a wall and let him pick his spot to run the football. How about the defense there? Swarming to it and not allowing that to happen. Did not let him get downfield.
They don't want to waste his outstanding field position on this opening drive as they come up on third down. Play clock winding down. Throwing on third down, Stafford. And this is going to be incomplete.
Right, let's go ahead and try and get into the body and the mind of the linebackers. Yeah, I know they're bigger and stronger than I ever was, but in this situation, they understood what was going on as much as the offensive guys, because the offensive guys always taught find the first down sticks and make the play. On defense, what do you want to do? Guard the first down line. Make sure they don't get there and tackle them in front. They're able to drop in their zone coverage, figure out where the first down line was, and end up making the play, swatting it away so they couldn't get the completion.
And now inside the red zone, the offense will operate. Now a toss play. This is White. And he is going to lose yardage here. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
There are so many times during camp and practice that you get bored as a player doing regular drills. But how about that shed and skate drill right there by the linebacker? You do it each and every day. Get the blocker away and get into the backfield and make a big-time tackle. That's what we just saw.
Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively. They'll need to get the playoff quickly. Here's Stafford. And that is caught. Touchdown, Detroit. Herman Moore from 19 yards away. And the Lions are going to take a first quarter lead. Good to see Herman Moore back in the end zone. 62 touchdowns back in his Lions career.
Not a bad run. And actually, a really good job of catching a lot of passes that turned into those touchdowns. Third all-time on the Lions list. That's pretty impressive.
Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. It's a very short kick, taken right at the 20. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past. Down Brady and break the tight end's got it, and he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38 yard line. It'll be a gain of 4, and it's a second down.
That coach is always harp on the quarterback reading the defense and getting it to the open man. That's good recognition there. And how about what he did after the catch?
Yeah, hit your tight end, let him get some rack.
Yeah, when he gets moving, not many guys want to come over and put a hit on him, do they?
And that one goes incomplete. He's maybe lucky it wasn't a fumble as he got hit as he threw it.
It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball, and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it. And the defense has it covered. It's intercepted. Oh, he tried to pitch it, and the ball's loose. And now here comes Kansas City. And they had the fumble last time that led to a touchdown. That's a no-no. We'll see what they do here this go-around.
A big no-no. Put that in capital letters. Turning it over. The other team takes it down and scores. That can be a deflator for a football team. Now it's up to the offense to get back out on the field and pick things up.
Now they're out there. We'll see if they can pick those things back up.
One of the toughest things about playing defensive back is pattern reading, trying to figure out what they're doing. And on that one, they had the fly, just sending a guy downfield with the in route accompanying it, what people call a dag.
And now a fumble. Brady loses the football. But it looks like the Chiefs are going to get it back.
On plays like this where the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back. Because this is the quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or have moved away from him. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
That's going to be knocked away and incomplete.
I like the boldness, and I like that they took a shot downfield, but it was well covered, and he was able to get a hand in and knock it away.
He gets this away. It's a good one, drawing toward the sidelines. And this punt goes out of bounds, and it'll be marked inside the 40. Here's the Lion offense now as they get ready to take over. And they were able to punch it in the end zone last time. They'll be looking to do that again here for the defense. Obviously, they'll be looking to stop them from punching it back in the end zone.
It always is punch counter punch, isn't it? And which team has the advantage? Well, let's just go back. Last time on offense, they rolled downfield, got into a good rhythm. You can see a little more bounce in and out of the huddle. You can see the sideline really get into the game. So defensively, you're thinking to yourself, how do we take that away from them? How do we get the advantage back? Let's see what they come up with. I think pressure is always the first way to go.
You love pressure.
I love it.
We'll see if they dial it up this drive. Second and 10, Stafford again. This is White on the screen. Give him 3 on the screen. He couldn't break free, and it's third down.
In order for a screen pass to break big, a lot of things have to come together and be well executed. But all it takes is one small.
Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. He couldn't get away there on third down. The pressure too much, and he's sacked for a loss of 12. Jake Chabon to punt it away. Here with Charles Davis, Brandon Gaudin, as the Lions are in possession of the football here to begin quarter number 2, but likely not for long as they're in punt formation to kick it away. Here's Jacob Shum now as the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. And now a low liner. I think he mishit it. Now Sanders. Only 29 yards on the punt there. Definitely not his best. And it's Chiefs football. First and 10. Here's the Kansas City offense now as they get set to take over. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with a game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
On play action, now Brady. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked by the Hall of Famer Mel Blount. And they yard line. So the Lions offense ready to go back out onto the field. They're out in front. Last time they had to punt it away. We'll see if they can add to their lead now.
They don't want to go out and punt it away again. This team now wants to get a cushion, put people away. They want to run their offense and have it end up in the end zone.
And he is going to lose yardage here. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
Stephon Tuitt came out of Notre Dame as another one of those really tall defensive ends, and just wondered, would they be able to have the leverage to bend and make plays? I think he just gave us an answer with that tackle.
Here's Stafford now on second down. Oh, a hit. He lost the football. Stafford puts it on the ground. And his guys are going to take over at the 21-yard line. And now here comes Kansas City. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive? Or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack to see how they attack him here. This is Howard on second down. And this carry not as productive. He's swallowed up at the line of scrimmage. And they'll lose a yard that time, and that's going to lead to a third down. Well, they were handed great starting field position on this drive, but now they face a third and four. Here's Brady to throw. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And he's able to pick up the first down before he's tackled right at the 10.
Would it be safe to say that as precise as routes are supposed to be run in the NFL, maybe they're not quite as precise in college ball?
That's accurate, yeah.
And I think we saw a college route in the NFL there. Just find the soft spot, find the dead zone, and find the first down. And that's what he just did.
Throwing on second down. He rifles one that's intercepted. A great read and it's picked off. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football. Obviously not what you're looking for. You've got the lead. You've got to protect the football.
So in other words, someone got lucky because they've been moving the ball really well and wearing them down. In this case, though, giving up the football doesn't make them very happy. They can't wait to get back out there and atone for it.
Yeah, try to atone for it here on this drive. They begin the drive on the ground. It's White. Oh, and he's not going to make it out of the end zone. The push too strong, and that'll be a safety. So this is where a defense can really pin back its ears, bring it all, sell out to stop the run. This time, it'll earn them 2 points.
They definitely guessed right here. A run blitz all the way, and that's a bad feeling for a running back when he knows he's got to at least get it over the goal line. But all he sees are opposing jerseys.
Now the Chiefs offense, they get ready to head on the field. And with 3 interceptions thrown already, we'll see. Do they rely more on the ground game here?
They may have to change things offensively to try and settle things down, not just for the guys.
Pressure up the middle, and down he goes. Bud Dupree in there to pick up his second sack now of the afternoon.
Well, the beauty of screen passes is they take a little time to develop, and they can often hit big. But sometimes they take too long to develop, and sometimes you get sacked.
Yeah, what's perfectly called for it? And this is caught! And he takes this into the end zone for a Chiefs touchdown. A big play there. 55 yards. And the Chiefs have taken the lead. And he's got it to make it now 9-6. Forbath to send it away now following the touchdown. This is taken at his four. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. So out now come the Lions. And the last time they had the football, they surrendered 2 points on the safety. They don't want to do that one again.
No, not at all. It's almost like a bases clearing double, isn't it? Give up a couple of runs.
Sure.
just messes things up for you offensively. But now they've got to go ahead, take it, set it aside, and move forward.
Well, this is taken in. It's complete. A really nice gain of 25 yards.
It's a game of matchups, and that's why you take your receivers and move them around a bunch, especially your best guys. And when they work out of the slot, you often hear the coaches talk about how great it is because it gives you a two-way go. You can break out or you can break in. That makes it hard to defend.
Completed pass play. Now let's see if they go back to the air or to the ground. To throw on second down is Stafford. Oh, he dropped it. They were looking for him in the middle third. He couldn't catch it. Now third down. And the offense looking to pick up the first down after the second down incompletion. Throwing on third down, Stafford. They'll set up the screen. This is Williams. And the screen does get him nine, but it also brings up a fourth down. It would appear Sean Payton's made the decision here. They will go for it on fourth. They run. It's Williams. And he will have first down yardage as he's brought down at the 41. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. To throw is Stafford. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
The good signal call is we'll never go back in the huddle and play the blame game because they need those guys to protect him. But on that last run, his offensive line, they lost their leverage very quickly, and that's why they were able to get to him and hit him as he tried to throw the football and force an incompletion.
He'll rifle this one deep, and this is caught, and he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Detroit. Mike Wallace, 41 yards, and the Lions are going to jump back in front. Stafford's going to try and throw for it. And unable to connect. They don't tight. But in the secondary, though, they were ready.
And I think that in most places on the field, if you have that much time to throw the ball, someone's going to shake free and you'll find an open receiver. But condensed near the goal line on a two-point conversion, all that extra, you know, there's not any extra field. So it kind of closes in on them, and that allows you to cover a little bit better.
And now here comes Kansas City. And the ball backed way up. So thinking with this amount of time on the clock, probably just sit on it, and we'll see these two teams go to the lockers.
Yeah, I don't think you want to overthink it in this situation. Either side of the ball. Just go ahead and finish up the half and get.
That's caught at the 25. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. So the D-line's going to spread out. Brady now on first down. Now they set up the screen. That's complete. And they take him down, losing yardage back at the 27. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. They'll come out in the pistol. On second down, here's Brady. That is caught at the 7. And they do get him down, but he's inside the 5 all the way to the 3. First half in the books. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number 3. The Lions offense now with a football first here to begin quarter number 3. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking to extend that lead.
And this is where I enjoy talking about one of my favorite subjects, tendency breakers, or counters as I also like to call them. You've done things in a certain way in the first half, and they've had the ability to see what you've done. They're going to make their adjustments. So guess what? You adjust yourself and try and stay ahead of the pace because you are looking for some separation in this ball game.
The adjustment to the adjustment.
Without a doubt. Show them one thing, hit them with something else.
On second down, here's Stafford. Oh, a hit. He lost the football. Stafford puts it on the ground. And he has brought this one back. A fumble recovery for a Chiefs touchdown. And a big turning point here in the second half, Charles, after that play.
All you're trying to do is change momentum, flip things around for your team. You're just trying to take the ball away. How about when you take it away and score? That really changes things.
And you can bet they're preaching two hands on the ball here as the kick's away following that fumble return. That'll be taken in the end zone. And this return nets positive as he gets past the 25 and up to the 27-yard line. The Lions offense, they get ready to head back onto the field. Now a first down throw, Stafford, and hauled in by Pitta. A gain of six there on first.
When you execute a drag or a crossing route really well and give them a chance to let it develop a little bit, you can gain some significant yardage hitting your tight end on that one.
So they complete the pass, and now they face a second down. One receiver left, two to the right. Here's Stafford now on second down. Goes underneath here to White. And he's finally taken down, but not before getting across midfield and across the 45-yard line.
We can talk all we want about football being a game of strength and brawn. It's also a game of mismatches, and they're trying to create one there, getting it to their back out of the backfield to make a bigger play.
As we often say, get it to him in space, let him use his leg.
Yeah, if he can get a matchup against a linebacker or maybe a defensive end dropping out in a zone blitz, he's going to win that battle just about every time.
On second and 10, Stafford. This is White on the screen. And he'll get it down on the play to the 37. Give him six on the screen, but now it's third down.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass. Looked like it was coming together. Looked like there was an opening. Still, ended up with a solid game.
And he gets the first down here as he's taken down at the 24. That one goes for 13 yards, and it moves the sticks. They're going to hurry back to the line now. They stay on the ground with White. And he'll get a couple here down to the 22. A sea of Chiefs jerseys in there that time to make the stop.
Tough day, tough sledding right there, and it's been that way the entire game. Not a whole lot of room to ramble for him.
Yeah, you're right. It's been that way all afternoon. Didn't get a whole lot better there. He'll set up the screen. This is Williams. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. It's an 8-yard pickup and leads to a new set of downs. And now they're in the hurry-up. Now a first down carry. It's Williams. And power running here down to the 6-yard line. A good run there on first down, and it'll leave him with a second and two.
Some runs are blocked so well, you almost forget that someone has to carry the ball to gain the yardage. The leverage by the offensive line to create space up front, really well done. The previous play was a nice run, so they came back with the draw. I think they were trying to fool the defense into thinking they would throw the ball and wanted to run it again. Unsuccessful, but this team is definitely showing they want to keep it on the ground. I know ultimately that feels like a good defensive play, but I know it's really not. They had a chance to keep points off the board. Now they have a chance to kick a field goal by missing that shot.
Yeah, especially at this spot in the field. He's got to be upset he couldn't come up with that INT. And that field goal caps an 11-play drive.
That's a lot of offense to run to only get 3 points, but they'll take them. Anytime you can put anything on the board, you run to your sideline somewhat happy.
And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. And now here comes Kansas City. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking for some separation here as we begin the third quarter.
I like the way you term that, because now I think they go a little bit deeper into their playbook. They like what they did in the first half. That worked okay. But in order to get the separation that you just talked about, change things up a little bit. Change your tendencies, try and hit them a little bit more with some things they didn't see in the first half.
We'll see if they do just that. They go with Howard again. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. Officially no gain on the play, and they're left with a third and eight. Wasn't able to get anything, no gain. Fumbled once already. Maybe he's being a little careful. Not necessarily on that play, but I'm sure that's in his mind somewhere.
Oh, without a doubt, because protecting the football is job one for anyone who's carrying it. And that's exactly what he tried to do on that play, but it didn't gain him any yardage.
Back now in Pittsburgh. This one's still anybody's ball game. It's a one-point difference here as we begin the fourth quarter of play. So the offense has it first and 10. Now a play fake here on first down. He's going to go for a big play downfield. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the 40 points last time. But they didn't want 3 points because they were well within range of scoring a touchdown. We'll see if they can do better now.
I'm with you on that one. Let's just go ahead and be frank about the whole thing. The only one happy about the 3 points.
The kicker.
Exactly. He put it through the post. That's going to help him in contract time. But that offense, they're thinking, let's get in the end zone this time.
I don't know if that helped him in contract time. You could have kicked that one through.
I don't know about that.
Toe bash.
I don't know about
toe
that.
Bashed it.
Super toe. I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
And the D-line pinching together must be expecting the run. Stafford. And they can't get the long connection as it falls incomplete. Just 1 yard to go. They come out here in the eye. On third and short, going with their tight end. They get 5 out of that one, and it moves the chains. So the run gets them the first, and now they operate with a fresh set of downs. They come up in an offset eye. On the toss, here's White. And he'll find some space up to about the 25. 8 yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on second and short.
I know the toss play begins with the guy taking the snap and turning around and tossing it to the runner. But where the real intrigue is can they seal the edge, whether it's an offensive tackle or a tight end, in the direction they want to run the football. If they do that, that's the result that you get, that type of a gain. If they don't, oftentimes, it's not a very successful play.
The offense certainly looking to score some points, but they also need ball security here late as we get down to the final moments of this one. On first down, Stafford here. Left side here to Sanders. No gain there on the completion, second and 10. And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up. To throw on second down to Stafford. Over the middle and into the hands of his receiver, Moore. Time for a break. We'll come back, see what transpires after this. Two receivers left, one to the right. He's back to throw. Now they go screen, it's complete. And to the 42-yard line here and brought down there. Call it a 1 yard gain on the play, and it'll be a second down. And they're going to hurry back to the line now. Back to throw. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
Well, any caused incompletion is good for a defense. But when you add to it, you get a little hit on the quarterback, knock him to the ground, make him think a little bit, hopefully knock him off his game, especially in a game of this magnitude, this tight in the fourth quarter. You gotta feel pretty good as a defense.
Play number 9 on the drive coming up, and they need 9 yards on third down. He'll look to throw, and he's got his man in stride, complete. They get only 4 that time as that leads us to a fourth down.
Partner, I think that completion takes the definition of dink and dunk to a different level, doesn't it?
It does, and the defense was right there, kind of played into their hands. They'll look to throw. He's got his man. It's Williams. It's a gain of 6 on the play, and they're able to pick up the conversion here on fourth down. And quickly, they get to the line. to throw. And on the catch right side, this is Sanders. Give him 9 there on the first down completion. And a really long drive here, and it goes on and on. They're going to go with a tight end here on the running play. And he'll do a nice job here just to fight his way back to the line of scrimmage. A couple of cheats there to bring him down. They come out with one back and 3 tight ends. Throwing to Stafford. James has it. And he gets this one all the way down inside the 15.
And Brandon, from our time in college football, where receivers weren't running the traditional NFL route tree, one thing they did learn, find open areas, find soft spots, and set up and catch the ball. And I think we just saw that there.
Yeah, we saw that indeed picking up. Now here's a defensive timeout called by the Chiefs. It's just their first. They've got 2 more to use here in the final stages. They give it off here to the tight end. And he'll get this one down to... And the Chiefs are going to signal for and be granted another timeout. That'll leave them with just 1 remaining in this fourth quarter of play. A carry here for the big tight end. And a short pickup there down to about the 9. And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here. That'll be their 3rd and final stoppage here as we step aside. And this one is right through. And it's celebration time on that sideline as they have taken the lead in the final seconds. And you know, in an era of cost-cutting and maximizing your roster, this is a club that does not skimp on special teams, and in these situations, it pays dividends.
And that's great vision by the organization. When the difference between winning or losing depends on who you have kicking the ball, would you rather have a street free agent out there or a solid pro?
It was fun down to the very end. They got the points late, right before the whistle. Then the ensuing kickoff. They were hoping for magic on the other side, but couldn't get that spark.
Fun if you won. And fun for us, because we got to watch it and call it. That magic that you were talking about didn't occur at the end, but what a game all the way through.
So that'll do it from here for Charles Davis and the rest of our crew. I'm Brandon Gaudin. You've been watching Madden Ultimate Team on EA Sports. For more, check us out at easports.com/Madden. With that, we sign off from Heinz Field.